Good morning, children. Welcome you back for session 2 of class 8 first language English. Hope all of you are safe and healthy. Children, last time we learnt about the sacrifice of Karna, where we were dealing with chapter 7, the great sacrifice. We saw the introduction, we answered the questions, and we learnt few glossary words. Now, just to brush up your glossary words, the first word was discontent, which means dissatisfaction. So we framed a sentence: Soumya was discontented with her marks. And precious, that is valuable or dear, precious stones are used in jewelry making. Trembling, that is shaking. Sakshi was trembling due to cold. Shriek, scream or cry out. Anushka got scared and started shrieking. In previous class, we saw the characters, that is Panna, Banbir, Padma and Champa. Now, we'll go to prose 7, The Great Sacrifice. Children, this is actually a drama, and I have brought the drama exactly as it is in the textbook so that you will develop the habit of reading. This is an introduction of the prose, The Great Sacrifice, where Ranasanga was the king of Mewar, died due to ill health, and his queen became very sick in that depression. So she called her trustworthy mistress and told her that she should take care of the infant prince Uday Singh, who is the future king of Mewar. Can you see that picture? The queen's picture and the mistress picture. The queen asked Panna to promise her that she would take care of the prince. After saying this, the queen handed over the infant prince Uday Singh to her mistress Panna and breathed her last. So queen was very sick. Since somebody had to take care of the infant, a small child, she requested Panna to take care of Uday Singh, who will be future king of Mewar. And she handed over the child to her and breathed her last. Now this is the scene. Here, the bedchamber of the infant prince Uday Singh in the palace of Chittor. The prince is sleeping on his ivory bed, and his nurse Panna, who is young, a Rajput woman, is sitting on another bed. Her little son, who is of the same age as the prince, is lying asleep beside her. A maid Padma comes in. So this is in the format of dialogues. I have given as it is, children. Padma, where is the prince? Panna, there he is, and here is my son. Both of them have just fallen asleep. Padma, I'm worried. Children, after this, I will not read the name of the character. I will read it as dialogue. As soon as Padma enters the palace room, she asks Panna, where is the prince? Then Panna shows that her son and prince, they have just fallen asleep. So Padma says that she is worried. What for? Yes, I too am worried. Everything has been going wrong since the death of Ranaji. Nobody seems to be happy. The nobles are quarreling among themselves. They have become mean and selfish. So here Panna says she is also worried because everything is wrong after the death of Ranaji, that is Ranasanga, and nobody seems to be happy because all the nobles are quarreling among themselves for what? For the position. for the throne, and they have become so mean and selfish, Padma. And Manbir has become very ambitious. Do you think the nobles like him? They have to like him. They are not strong enough to dislike him. But isn't he grateful to them? So here, Manbir has become very ambitious. Why? He wants to become the king of Mewar. And nobody likes him. But nobody is so dare to say that they dislike him also. Grateful? Can snake ever be grateful to anyone? Manbir and gratitude belong to two different worlds. I say, Padma, this Manbir is a curse to the house of Mewar. We have to be careful of him. So Panna says, snake can never be grateful. Whatever you do, it's going to definitely bite you. So Manbir and gratitude belongs to different world only, two different world. Padma, but isn't he son of our late Rana and half brother of our prince? So who is Manbir here now? He is the son of late Rana and he is a half brother of the prince. How sad, no children? He may be anything, but I don't trust the man. He has killed some nobles and has crushed the others. They don't dare to say or do anything against him. They are afraid of him and he does what he likes. There is discontent among the people and there is discontent in the army. So, how is he? He has killed so many nobles. He has crushed. So, nobody is able to be against him. And everybody is discontent. We saw this word, right? They are not satisfied in the army. Why doesn't the army throw him out? It can't. Manbir has formed a party of his own. There are some strong men on his side and everyone is afraid of him. So, why they are not able to throw him out of Mewar? Because he has become very strong by forming his own party, right? So everybody is afraid of Manbir. Unfortunate Mewar, your troubles will never end. What can we do, Panna? We can do a lot. Let the time come. I haven't yet told you the worst about Manbir. So this is the discussion between Padma and Panna. So what she says, Mewar itself is so unfortunate. When will the troubles of Mewar end? Because they don't have a strong leader who can fight for people. So they are feeling helpless, but she says they can do a lot when the time comes. And there is a worst thing about Manbir. What is that? What is it, Padma? Listen, Manbir wants to be the permanent Rana of Mewar. He has resolved to kill the prince. So why is he doing all this? He is ambitious. He wants to be the permanent king of Mewar. He doesn't want to wait till infant Uday Singh grows up and he becomes the king. No, he wants to be the permanent king. And I have resolved to save the prince. The prince's mother was dying. She said to me, Panna, I have lost everything except my precious child. I am leaving him to your charge. Be a mother to him and protect him from all harm. We saw that in the beginning, no children. Rani handed over infant Uday Singh to Panna, saying that she should take care of him. So she says that I have promised Rani and I will definitely keep up my promise and I will take care of the prince. I promised that I would give my life to save the life of the prince. And she died smiling. Manbir cannot kill the prince as long as Panna lives. I will fulfill my promise to my late mistress. So, the sound of someone running outside. So, what Panna says, I have promised that I would give my life to save the prince. How difficult it is, no children, to be so faithful. Right? So, since she has promised the queen, she says, I don't mind giving my life, but still I will save the prince. Listen, there is somebody outside. Who can it be? It must be one of the guards. A maid named Champa enters panting. So when the discussion is going on between Padma and Panna, they heard some sound outside. So who entered? Champa entered panting. She was tensed. Make haste. Do what you can do to save the life of the prince. You haven't any time to lose. Banbir will be here in a few minutes. He's talking to a man outside. He is only 100 yards away from here. So what is the news brought by Champa? She says, make a haste, be hurry. Because who is coming? Banbir is coming. He is just 100 yards away and he is talking to someone. How do you know he is coming to kill the prince? So Champa answers, he has a naked sword in his hand. See the picture, children? He has a naked sword in his hand. He has brought a sword. That means he is sure to kill the prince. Okay. All right. The time to do or die has come. I must save the life of the prince or die with him. So she says, Champa and Padma, please help me to save the life of Rana Sangha's child. So she quickly lifts the prince from his bed, changes his clothes and puts him in a basket and then covers them with flowers and leaves. You can see that picture, children, that she has put the child in the basket and she has covered the prince with flowers and leaves. So she says, it's all right. Now it's time to just do or die. We cannot give up. We have to save the life of prince. So she quickly changes his clothes and puts him in the basket and covers the basket with flowers and leaves. Take this basket out of the palace, hide yourselves near the gate and wait for me there. Lifting up the basket, I'll carry this most precious basket under my arm. Champa, follow me. Where are we going to take the prince? No one in Mewar will keep him in his house. So, how faithful these maids are, the mistresses. She says, take this basket out of the palace and wait near the gate. So, Padma says, I will carry it like a most precious thing. We saw that word precious, which is dear, which is more valuable, right? So, she will take it outside with uttermost care. So, Champa says, no one is ready to help in Mewar. So, what we are going to do? Don't worry. I have already thought about it. We'll take them to Asa Shah, who is a good man and a friend of ours. I am sure he protects the prince. Now, hurry up and be careful. When Panna, Padma and Champa, they are literally scared. They don't know what to do. Okay. They say, Champa says, nobody in Mewar is ready to help them because they are scared of Banbir. They may kill them also if they try to help the prince. So what to do? Panna says, not to worry because she has already spoken to Asa Shah, the other king of the other place, who is ready to help and save the life of Prince Uday Singh. And she tells them to make haste, be hurry up and be very careful in handling the child. So, the maids go out taking the infant prince with them quickly, dresses her own child in the clothes of the prince and puts him in his bed. She looks at him for a few minutes, kisses him several times and lies down on her bed. The sound of footsteps outside. The Banbir enters the room hurriedly. Panna gets up from the bed. So what's happening here now? In the room, she asks the maids to take the child, take the prince in the basket and go out. And what is happening here? she dresses her own child in the clothes of the Prince Banbir to show that this child itself is Prince Banbir. She puts her own child on the ivory bed where Prince Uday Singh used to sleep, and she kisses him several times. The love of mother is never ending and you can never measure it. It is in abundance. No, children? Is it not? Even at home, whatever we do, mothers are mothers. They love us beyond the limits. There is no limit at all for their love. They love us beyond their limit. So she just kisses him. And she knows that something serious is going to happen to the child. But still, and she just lies down beside the child. So she hears the footstep. Who is walking in? Banbir came. And he enters the room. So Panna pretends that she was sleeping and she gets up. He asks, "Where is the prince?" "Not so loud, please. He is asleep." "Where is he?" So Banbir is really fierce and he is come to just kill. He has resolved his mind to kill the prince. He says, "Where is the prince?" She says, "Don't talk so loudly because the child is sleeping." He says, "It's okay. Where is he?" Panna points to her child with the trembling hand. Banbir, trembling. You saw this word, no, children? Trembling. Trembling hand, Banbir rushes to the bed and kills the child with his sword. Panna shrieks and falls down on her baby's body. Banbir looks around and goes out of the room. So, when he asks where is the child, what does she do? She points towards her child saying that that is Prince Uday Singh. So, Banbir just rushes there and without having a second thought, he just kills the child. And Panna shrieks, she screams and falls down on the baby's body, who is dead. We saw these two words, no, children? Trembling, shaking, shrieks, screaming aloud, and she just falls fainted. Banbir looks around and he goes out of that room. So Panna is, before she falls down, in a choked voice, loudly she says, "Mistress, I have kept my promise to you. I have saved the life of the prince." How pathetic, no, children? It is very, 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 very difficult to be so faithful. Especially, child or children are the world of mothers. They can never compromise on their children. Whatever we do, they just say, "My child is the best, my daughter is the best, my son is the best." Right? Even though they don't eat, they try to feed their own children. So that is the condition of a mother. Here, because she has promised her queen that she will save the life of the child, she did not think twice. She just sacrificed her own child. She put her child in the stake. And the same sacrifice we saw in Karna also, right? Karna gave his own life. He sacrificed his own life that we saw in session 1 of the same prose. So that's why that was given as pre-reading task for you for this lesson, where that is also related to sacrifice of life. Here, Panna has sacrificed her child's life for the sake of saving Uday Singh, infant Prince Uday Singh, where she had promised the queen. So great, no, children? It is really a great sacrifice. No? eaters, it cannot be defined in words. Such a great sacrifice Panna did just to save the life of Prince Uday Singh, the future king of Mewar. Did you all understand, children? You all understood, right? Now it's the grammar time. Now we learn grammar, that is the present perfect. Children, in this I'll show you how to form present perfect and when to use present perfect. So before we start, let's know how to conjugate the verb. These are the verb in singular form. To have. To have. I have, you have, he has, she has, and it has. And we'll see the plural form of these singular words. That is, we have, you have, and they have. Children, let's first know in the English verb, we have regular verbs and irregular verbs. Now, these are the regular verbs. Look at these sentences, children. I have painted the door yellow. They have paid for dinner themselves. So, these are in the present perfect. Now, how to form a present perfect using these regular verbs? That is, have or has. You will add past participle, that is, verb and ed. Very simple, children. Okay, verb plus ed. Take a look at these sentences. We can make a past participle by adding ed to the infinite form of the verb. Okay, children. Now, let's look at these singular forms. I have worked there. You have listened carefully. He has cleaned the table. He has cleaned the table. She has placed it on the floor. It has snowed. So, how to form present perfect using these regular verbs? I told you, by adding ed to the verb. Now, see this, children. These are infinite verbs added ed. That is, work is an infinite verb. Added ed, it becomes walked. That is a present perfect. Watch, you add ed and it becomes watched. Mark becomes marked when you add ed. So, this is present perfect for the regular verbs. Now, how to form a present perfect for the verbs ending in an e? See, read these words, live, live, close, close, wipe, wipe, etc. So, all these words are ending with e. Now, it's very simple, where you will just add d to the infinite verb. Have, has, plus past participle, that is infinite verb plus d. I have lived here for quite some time. I have lived here for quite some time now. See, you added only d to live, lived. You added d to close. He has closed the window. I have wiped the floor. Now, this becomes a present perfect. Now, how to form a present perfect if the verbs are ending in a y, that is preceded by a consonant, spy or study, etc. Here y becomes I. He has spied on his neighbors. S-P-Y, spy. Now y became I in present perfect. Now spied on his neighbors. We have studied hard. study, y became I, studied, I-E-D. Yes, children, you understood? It's very simple. Now, how to form a present perfect using irregular verbs? That is, have, has, and plus past participle. That is, unique present perfect form. For irregular verbs, we also use auxiliary verbs. That is, to have by adding the past participle for the irregular verbs. Past participle have unique present perfect form, children. Take a look at this. See these sentences. Read these sentences one after the other. I have built that shed with my own two hands. She has bought some flowers at the market. So, build has become built, and she has bought, buy becomes bought. That is, for the irregular verbs, the present perfect. We have run the marathon. Now, for the regular verbs, the present perfect in questions. Have, has, that is verb, infinite verb, plus ed. Has she talked to him yet? You are asking a question. So, to have in a question form, has she talked to him yet? Have you kicked the ball? Have they ever worked on a farm? So, this becomes the present perfect in question. Has, have. Now, for irregular verbs, have, has, adding past participle. That is the unique present perfect form I told you, no, for irregular verbs. Yes. Take a look at these sentences, children. Has she quit her job yet? Have you ever driven a car? Have they ever paid for dinner? So, quit, driven, paid. Drive, driven. Quit, quit. Paid, paid. Has, have. So, this is for the irregular verbs. So, children, today we learnt glossary words. We read the prose, the drama, we analyzed, and now, and you also learnt grammar, present perfect. Now, it is the time for home assignment. Children, I hope all of you are writing and showing it to your teachers. Please copy down these questions and complete. Why were Padma and Panna worried? Name the person who was ambitious. What is he compared to? Why were the other nobles powerless against him? What did Banbir make up his mind to do? Why did Panna change the prince's clothes? Whose clothes did Panna make her baby wear? Whose bed did she put him in? Who did Banbir kill? Did he realize his mistake? So, copy this questions. Answer and show it to your teachers. Thank you, children. Thank you, one and all.